Hello children, in this lesson we are going to learn the next law of standard identity, that is standard identity 3. In our last lessons we have learned standard identity 1 and standard identity 2 laws. Here is the standard identity 3 law. A plus B into A minus B. Right? I normally prefer not to just give you the formula, make you learn how to derive that formula. So if you are given a plus b into a minus b, how do you find the value? We learned during the multiplication of algebraic expression, you take the first term and take each first factor and take each term within it. So first factor is a plus b and its first term is a. Multiply it with the multiplier, which is a minus b. So this can be written as a into a minus b plus b, just write this as is, plus b into a minus b, right? If it was given a plus b plus c, you would have written a into a minus b into a minus b plus c into a minus b, right? So this is what you get, and then using the distributive law, you can easily multiply it further, a into a minus a into b. So this term is now broken into two terms, a into a minus a into a minus a into b. Same way, this term is now having two terms, b into a minus b into b, right? So a into a is a squared, a into b is ab, plus b into a is ba minus b squared. Ensure you are not doing any mistake in the sign, right? And we know ba is same as ab. So we can write a square minus ab plus ab minus b square, and minus ab plus ab is 0, right? Minus 1 plus 1 is 0, or minus 5 plus 5 is 0, or minus x plus x is 0, right? So we are with these two goes away, so you are left with a square minus b square, minus ab plus ab goes away. So this is the standard identity 3 law, which is a plus b into a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. Let's take some example. Suppose you are given 983 square minus 17 square. One way is multiply 983 by 983, multiply 17 by 17, and then whatever answer you get here, subtract it with whatever you get here. But this is lot of operation. We can use standard identity 3 to solve it easily. So think A as 983 and B as 17. We can easily write 983 square minus 17 square as A plus B into A minus B. So that is A is 983 and B is 17. So this will become bracket 983 plus 17, and A minus B you write it as 983 minus 17. 983 plus 17, you can do it on copy or in your mental math. 983 plus 17, 3 plus 7 is 10. 1 goes here, 8 plus 1, 9. 9 plus 1, 10. So this will become 1000. Right? 1000. And this is 966. So 1000 into 966. And 966 into 1000 is 966000. So without doing huge operation, we were able to find the answer very quickly using the identity 3 law. But you need to ensure that the numbers given are in this form, a square minus b square. Right, children? Let's take another example. Now, this time of an algebraic expression. You are given 5p minus 2q into 5p plus 2q. Right? Now, this is reverse. You are given a plus b into a minus b. How can you write it? You can write it as a square minus b square. Right? So what you can do is think this is a, this is b, a minus b into a plus b can be written as a square minus b square. Remember children, entire 5p is a, entire 2q is b. So write the bracket, 5p whole bracket square minus 2q square. Why this? Because a plus b into a minus b, or a minus b into a plus b. You can swap this also, right? A minus b into a plus b. That's what it's here. My a minus b into a plus b is equal to a square minus b square. So I've written it's as a square, a is 5p and b is 2q. And this can be simplified further. 5p whole square is 5 square p square, which is 25p square, minus 2q whole square is 2 square q square, which is 2 square is 4, q square is q square. Right? Mn whole square is equal to m square n square. 5 into 5 into p into p. 25p square. 2 into 2 into q into q, which is 4q square. So identity 3, very useful. If you are given this, you can write it like this. Or if you are given this, you can write it like this. That's all in this lesson, children. Bye-bye.